Welcome back, everybody. This is episode 7 of my Transport Fever series. So we're going to get right into this time lapse. There's a lot I want to get done in this episode, and actually it's going to run just a little bit long. But there's quite a lot of stuff I'm going to be working on. And it took me quite a long time to get this little junction area that you can see here in Castle set up. There was a lot of fidgeting around with the tracks to get them to lay down the way I wanted them to. And there's a lot of problems with getting the bridges to sort of not interfere with each other and allow tracks to run underneath and all kinds of stuff. So it just took me a long time and a lot of trial and error to get it all set up the way I wanted. I wanted to create this sort of loop around junction, or actually I guess I should call it a roll-in roll-out station because that's what it is. I think I was talking about it some in the last episode. I wanted to create it here in Castle because it's going to act as a hub for the northwest section of the map, and then connecting down to the southwestern section of the map. So it's going to have to handle a lot of train traffic, and I actually... at least to me, it seemed like the trains got in and out a bit quicker doing a roll-in, roll-out style thing instead of having to come in and then turn around and go back out. Only because you can stack up the incoming trains a little bit and they don't have to sometimes wait for the other trains to be leaving before they can roll in. The lead-up areas are a little bit longer and they slow the trains down, which can give the trains that are in the station just enough time to load up and then roll out before the next trains are coming in. At least that's the idea. It doesn't quite work out that well, but I do need to create a larger station here. I've moved on to a couple more episodes that I've already recorded, and this station is not working out as well as I thought. It works out pretty well. But I do need to upgrade it to a 3 or 4 track station and then move the passenger line over a little bit and probably increase it to at least a 2 track. Just because having 2 lines on each platform, it's stacking up just a little bit too much and there's some slowdowns and things of that nature. So I'll have to come back and give this another go in one of my later episodes. But I'm not sure when I'm going to get around to that, so just stay tuned for it and I'll get to it eventually. Okay, so now that we're done with the time lapse, we're going to go ahead and show you what all I've been doing. I ended up doing that time lapse just because it took me quite a few hours to get pretty much the main line here and the main transfer station all set up with the new layout. And I had spent a number of hours off screen also trying out a few different layouts. And like number of trains and everything to try and get these lines a little more profitable and efficient. So yeah, let's just start here and I'll show you the oil well so you can see our production is over 200 now. And we've got quite a bit waiting. Let me bring up our lines here. I'll show you the railroad. So on our oil line, we now have 6 trains running. Each with a cargo capacity of 6 good, or, well, technically they're gonna, or, whatever, they're gonna have, like, 6 good wagons and 6, fuel wagons. And you can see one of our trains, because we're now in 1913, we got the larger wagon, so one of them's already been upgraded, so it's just 3 and 3, which we could actually add more onto that, because the trains are shorter, and we are stuck with just this 160 stations for right now. I don't know if we'll actually ever need to upgrade those. But yeah, so we'll be able to upgrade to the new cars at some point. And you can see here how our trains come in. They all the trains will enter from the left side and then exit on the right side. And then our plastics line only has 3 trains on it right now. It actually needs a 4th one, but we were waiting on some money. Because you can see we've got 84 seconds for the frequency on the oil line, but 115 on the plastics line. And we want to get those a bit closer together, just to make sure production stays up on these other places. So now we'll come over here and we'll take a look at the main station. So you can see here our plastics line, our passenger line from Corsham, and the freight line from Corsham all come down and converge on this single point. They go through a single tunnel. I did just the single tunnel to try and keep costs down, but honestly, it probably could have just stayed as 2 tracks, one dedicated for the passenger line or something, but it's not a real big deal. They clear out through here pretty quickly, so right now this isn't much of a bottleneck. But yeah, so they come out of the tunnel. And then you can see here where we split back into 3 tracks to get ready to stack them up for the station entrance. So this acts sort of as a parallel stacking area. Instead of having them all stacked up behind each other and then filling the tunnel and then creating a bottleneck, you can actually have them split out before the station. And then they roll in and out a lot faster. And then our food line coming down, you can see stays on this upper track, on be track 1 of the freight station, and then comes here and turns around. And we actually have a second turnaround spot on track 2 that will be used for our freight line that'll be coming up here through this pass in the south. So all that's set up. The only thing we don't really have right now is a turnaround point for our passengers that will be coming up from the south. We may have to put a third turnaround line on here that branches off of our passenger line, or have a turnaround over here or something. I'm not sure yet. We'll get to that when we get to that. But yeah, so if we look at our goods factory, you can see that we used to have about a 64 lead on wood over plastics coming in, but now that we've got this line running much more efficiently, we actually have a surplus of plastic and our wood line is not keeping up. And our wood line is still trucks, but those have been upgraded. If we go into our road section, you can see that we got new buses, so all those are in, and we got new freight trucks. These are Mercedes-Benz something something. They're just called the Benz in the game. But yeah, so all of our trucks have been upgraded to those, and we've actually added more to our planks line. And it's still not keeping up right now. I'd rather not try to put in a train that just basically runs back and forth right here. because that would kind of be a waste and we don't necessarily need it, but we will probably have to put a bunch more trucks on this line. And in fact, we may have to build a second freight depot, or truck station. I always want to call them depots, depots, whatever, but these are actual stations. But yeah, we might have to build a second one that's just for our planks line coming in, because with the two lines coming into Castle for deliveries, this does start to bottleneck up just a little bit. So yeah, that's the main turnaround station area. And then we come out here to our farm, and you can see we still got a bunch of livestock waiting. We actually have two lines coming through here now, which is why we have this turnaround area. We have our regular food lines, which are getting food from up here, and then coming all the way down. But now we've got a dedicated livestock line that just brings the livestock up and then comes back. And what I'm actually going to end up doing is changing the food line. So our livestock gets picked up at the farm, comes up, gets turned into food, and then those trains will come back to the farm with their food. The food will get dropped off here, and then we'll just have trains running from Castle out to the farm instead of all the way up to the food factory. So that should about half the travel time for those trains and make it that line a little more efficient and hopefully a little more profitable. It's going to start getting a little complicated with our trains coming from the quarry over to our construction factory. I haven't really thought about what we're going to do with that yet. I mean, I'm probably just going to have a track that runs more or less direct between the two. But I need to figure out if there's like a better way of doing it, like dropping off stuff here and then letting trains run. But yeah, what I was actually thinking just now is I could have quarry trains that run down to the farm, drop their material there, and then come back up to the quarry. And then we're gonna have trains coming out of the farm with the stone, bring it over to the construction factory, and then take those materials on into Corsham and Dulverton, and then just have to return to the farm to pick up more. That might be a good idea, kind of splitting that line in half just because it is kind of long. I gotta think about how I'm gonna do that, because then this station's gonna have to probably get upgraded to a third line, and a few other things. But yeah, so also I think we'll have food. See, I'm gonna have so many lines going everywhere that there's gonna be a lot of overlap for train lines. And I mean, I normally try to min-max stuff, even if it doesn't necessarily need to be, and I'm just trying to figure out what's the like absolute most efficient way of moving these goods around. But we'll probably just have a few like dedicated, like a food line coming down this way and then splitting off for Harrow, and then maybe bringing the food up through the pass to Corsham, and then using what I was just talking about for our Castle delivery. But yeah, so there's a lot that can be done here to still work on this and get it working a lot better. Real quick, if we bring up our income. So if we look back here at 1910, we can see that we are making income just under 12 million. And in the next couple years, now we're up almost another 2 million. So yeah, these lines are running a little bit better, and as I showed you, production is up, and I just got to start working on this wood line, get it a little bit better. But for the remainder of this episode, what I want to do is try and find another place that we can start making some easy money. Probably with some road freight and maybe some road passenger lines. So, for example, if we come down here, we can see we've got all of our steel mills, and then we've got coal and iron. Those are a bit far. That would definitely be a train network doing that. Let's just see if there's anything else we want to work on. Because I'd like to get some of these cities set up, since I've been ignoring almost all the map and exclusively working in just this one corner. And we're already up to 1913, so we're going to have a massive construction boom just to really start utilizing the map. So I'd like to try and do something about that right now. So right here, you can see we've got this quarry and then the construction factory. We could set something up right here pretty easy and start delivering into Wincanton. There's not much else around, but we could at least do that, and then we'd have this system already set up for delivering via train our construction materials on sort of this side of the map. Because of the way the things are set up, we have, I think, three construction materials factories. Yeah. We only have three construction material factories for the entire map. Actually, we have four. There's another one there. And I don't think there's any down here. Oh no, there is another one here. So we do actually have five. Oh no, even six. Okay. I thought there was actually much fewer than there actually are. but the problem with this one down here is there is no stone anywhere near it. So we'd have to be shipping stone from up here all the way down around, or via ship from the quarry up here. So actually probably won't end up using this one at all, which is okay. It would make it a lot faster for supplying Hingham, Southwick, and Alton. And actually even... Actually no, Margaret has one right there. But yeah, so the ones down here in the southeast corner, or no, southwest corner of the map, they would benefit from this one, but we're probably just gonna have to ship down from up here by Margate or something. We also have this nice oil well and refinery right here just across the river. We could probably use a ship transporting through there. But because we're going to have a train line running down from Harrow, that will already have a bridge across for the train line. So we could just come in and swing on the outskirts of Rumford and do both of those. So we also have a farm and a factory there. Wood and a planks factory, but we don't really want to do that right now until we can start shipping that to a goods factory or a machine factory. So I think we're just going to go ahead and start here with the construction materials. And this will definitely have to get upgraded later on. I just want to get a little extra income and just work on a different part of the map, since we've been focusing so much on that one area. I'm going to go ahead and set this city up a little bit. That's actually not what I wanted there. So we'll have something like that. I'm gonna build up a few roads here just so it's ready to expand. And then a this road out this way because it's going to be a more direct line. In fact, I'm just going to go ahead and upgrade this road already just to make sure that there's absolutely no possible traffic problems. Okay, that should be fine. So let's go ahead. Oh, and actually went through our money pretty fast. Wasn't really paying attention. So we'll just wait here a moment and we should get quite a bit of money. And as you can see in the time-lapse video, we had up to a $30 million loan while we were putting all this in. And you can see that we've already paid it back down to about $13 million and money is still coming in pretty well. And it actually looks like we've got quite a bit of fuel starting to stack up. So we're probably going to need another train on the plastics line fairly soon. And then plastics is dropped off because we're waiting on our planks to get delivered. Which is probably going to need even more cars. I already put a bunch more on, but let's go ahead and add at least another four. It actually looks like production has dropped off at the forest. Let's bring up the line real quick. So if we look at the wood, it's got a 30-second frequency. I'm going to add two more trucks. Hopefully production will start picking up here a lot more. We may need to add even more trucks onto this line. And I should probably just go ahead and upgrade the station just so it's ready. So yeah, production here really needs to pick up, which it's about, there we go, so now we're at 100, so soon it'll be trying to upgrade, so that's good there. Production's almost 200 at the planks factory, so that's good. Okay, so we've already got 5 million, 6 million, making money really fast now. I'm going to pay down this loan just a little bit. Gonna pause time and come back over here to one canton. And grab our truck station. Place it about as far out as we can. That should be good. And we definitely want to try to get this one as far down the road as we can. Because going up this hill is going to greatly slow down our vehicles. So every little bit that we can kind of game the system is going to help us. So it looks like right around here. It's going to be pretty expensive to put this in just because there's such a big hill. 140, 130, oop, I thought I saw 112 there. Oh, yep. But it's just outside, so we're going to have to put it in right around here. Come on, show me, there it is. Alright, so we'll just do it like that. Now we need a depot. And we're gonna need the depot to serve one canton. So we can just put it down this way. I think something like that'll be fine. Now that we've got a bunch of money, I'm going to go ahead and put in a few more roads just so everything's ready. I'm still trying to get a sense of how far apart the roads need to be to let the buildings build up through them. I think something like this should be just about right. Let's go ahead and upgrade. Should be able to run road through the middle here. Get some buildings on either side, fill us in a little bit more. Let me go ahead and do that. Okay, that's more than good enough for now. Line manager, and let's create our new line. We're going to go from the quarry over to our construction materials factory. So this is going to be roof crates, one canton, and this is stone. And actually, what we should go ahead and do is... So, when we build our train network... Let's see. Let's close this real quick so we can get a better view. Okay, so we're gonna have a train line come into Harrow and then possibly run down this backside to Lechlad. It's probably more like Lechlad. And then cross over and it can come up here to Winkenton. And then it'll split down this way for Rumford. So yeah, we're gonna have our train station probably on the south side of Winkenton. Oh man, that's some pretty rough terrain for our train to be going up. But yeah, by the time we're getting the train route over here, we should have plenty of money to put in some bridges and tunnels as we need them. Although, real quick, I just want to make sure that this can even come down through here. Yeah, it just looks like it's mainly going to be all tunnel. But it should be able to cut down through there without too much problem. So we can just have our train station over here. And the reason I wanted to check that out is so when we put in our freight station back here, it's going to act as our distribution station to enter Winkenton. And I want to make sure that a train station could actually be over here, so hopefully I don't have to move this too much again or set up the town differently. So we're just going to go ahead and take our truck station. And I think we can just place it here. It's going to be fine. Actually... Let's turn on our overlay. So once again, our stuff is kind of spread out a little haphazardly. Let me just connect this road up. It's annoying me. So it's kind of difficult to get our station in where it's going to cover everything. So we may have to go with... Yeah, we're probably going to have to go with one that covers our commercial and then one that covers our industrial. Which we've already been doing in our other towns, so it's fine with me. So we'll probably put this here. And then over on this side, something... I guess Actually, if we spin it this way, I can't get this one commercial building, of course, without placing this somewhere where I'm gonna have to destroy buildings. So I'd have to destroy four buildings there, but I would cover pretty much everything. Let me give her this weird road that it built. Okay. Let's see if we put this in here, if we can get full coverage. Not really. Like I said, this one commercial building is just outside. But I think we're just gonna go with it. I'm just gonna place this in here. Gonna grab a road real quick and just connect this over. Okay. And then we can place our distribution terminal out here. Gonna create a couple lines. So from the distribution into our commercial. So it's going to be road freight, Wincanton, commercial. And then our other line for the industrial. And we're actually going to click on our stone line. And then after coming over here, I want to rename this. Factory. So construction material factory. After it's done at the construction material factory, it'll come over here, stop at the exchange before heading back to the quarry. That way we get double use out of our trucks. They'll actually pull, or they'll pick up the construction materials that are finished and bring them for distribution in Wincanton. So we can actually rename this to I'm just going to name it CM. I know what it is. Construction materials. Okay, so now we need to buy some vehicles. So let's start off with, I think, 10 is a good number. Gonna go on the stone line. Or, well, wait, do we not rename it? Okay, there we go. So we're gonna go on the CM line for Wincanton. And then for right now, before things really start picking up, we're just gonna add three to our Wincanton commercial and three to the industrial. And we're probably going to need more trucks on the stone line. Oh yeah, so we got the class 74 or 75.4 Baden 6C. We're just going to obviously refer to it as the Baden from now on. This is a very good train. I've been looking forward to unlocking it. We're going to have to wait just a little bit to get some money for it. But I'm definitely going to be using it for pretty much all of our lines because it's a very good train. It does 90 kilometers an hour, has a lot of towing power, and it's relatively cheap to buy. Here we go, that's what I was looking for. So I just wanted to show you. So we've been using the PLM 220s, just over a million, and 450 kilowatts, and then 60 kilometers an hour. But the Baden is about 400,000 more. And we get 580 kilowatt power and 90 kilometers an hour. Compare that with the A3/5, which is starting to get a little bit older. It does 10 kilometers an hour more. It has a huge amount of towing power, but it also costs twice as much and twice as much to run per year. So these would be good for really long trains that really need that power or going up hills. But yeah, we have kind of limited use for that, and they're very expensive, so our Badens are going to be our bread and butter soon. Of course, we had just put in all these new PLM-based trains, so don't necessarily want to upgrade those quite yet. So yeah, you can see here our plastics line needs to massively get ramped up. There's a huge amount of stuff waiting. Production is almost 300. Okay, production's falling off there. Probably need more wood still. Oh no, actually our wood's doing okay. So it might just be because there's so much stacked up here. So what we're gonna do is, going to get new trains. So I was just talking about how great the Badens are. But I don't necessarily want the Baden mixed in with the PLM because of how fast it is. It'll just get held up behind our PLMs. Although we do have $6 million now, we could probably just replace the locomotives. Let me pull up the line real quick. Look at our plastics line. And look at our vehicles. So that one's 9 years old. 9 years. So they're all 9 years old on our plastics line, which is pretty young for our trains, because these will do 35 years before they start getting outdated. Oh, that's cool. I hadn't noticed that before. It tells you the running cost per kilometer. Or at least I assume that's what that is. It's kind of a cool statistic. But yeah, you can see our transport has massively skyrocketed after I redid these lines. And our income is also shot way up. Yeah, so we were barely doing 300,000, a little bit more further back before I started messing with the lines. I can't really, there's no way to show that, but yeah, we've shot way up now. It's very good. I think what we're going to do is just add a new PLM for the time being. I really like the Badens though. Should we just go ahead and use the Badens? I think we should. So what we're going to do is plastics line. let's just click on one of the trains. We're going to send it. Ah, screw it. We're just going to send them all to the depot. Yeah. So now if we look at this PLM, we can see it's getting pretty old. It's up to 13 years. It's pretty dirty. Let's see, where'd our other guys go? Okay, so they're still on their way. So our plastics line is currently running with 4 and 4. Honestly, what we're gonna do is just sell all of our old plastics line trains. So Maverick is 40 years old, so what we should actually do is turn him around, send him into the depot. I'm going to try and find Goose here, because he's got to be getting up there. 10 years, is it the guy that's down here? Nope, that's train 15. Dang it, where's Goose at? Oh, don't tell me I sold Goose and I didn't realize it. No, I split up Maverick and Goose, I think. And I didn't even realize it. Oh, nope, there he is. Oh, so Goose is somehow only 14 years old. I guess I upgraded him soon. Or not too long ago. But yeah, so now we've got these guys in here. If we look at Maverick. So that's getting to be a pretty old engine. We're actually just going to sell it. Move up the newer engine. Oh, actually, so sell off those cars. Do that. Yeah, let's just sell all those. I'm going to bring up our line real quick so I know how many to buy. So our oil line is using 6 and 6, so let's do 3 and 3. We'll need to add more cars soon, but this is okay for now until we get our plastics line fixed up. So first we need to rename him. This is Maverick again. And he's going back on the oil line. Okay, time to buy our new trains. So we're going to go with the Badens. I think 3 and 3 should be good, just like the guys running on our oil line. And we're going to want... Ooh, actually we need more money. Let's just take out some loan. Now I think with 3, we might be okay, just because they are the Badens, they're going to run a bit faster. So before we buy a fourth one, we're going to see how this does. Because once they're on this line heading towards the castle station, they will probably hit their top speed. Alright, so the Badens are super cool, so I definitely want to come down and watch them roll out. Let me slow down time first. Okay, we're gonna follow. Look at this sexy train. Yeah. The Badens are really nice looking, and I love our new cars we got. They look really cool. Our open cars kind of look like just cabooses, actually. But yeah, so, super awesome Baden. Ooh, can we change the color? I'm gonna see what it changes on it. Oh. Ooh. So... Oh god. Too bright. So is there not a way to... Oh, reset color, okay. Yeah, I don't know, I don't really care so much for coloring the trains. Maybe later on. But I just like how they look normally, so I'll just keep it as it is. Alright, so as you can see, the Baden's already up to 40 kilometers an hour. It's just barely out of the station. And it's got a full load, 24 and 27. Which, why is that 27? What is the new tank car? Oh, the new tank cars hold 9 as opposed to 8. It's kind of odd. But whatever, that's just more space for me. So, hitting 53. This actually might be limited by the track through there. I'm not sure. I think it is. I think the top speed through here is 53, which kind of sucks. I might want to work on that and try and make it a little smoother so that they can get up to speed faster. Come on, get up to speed. I'm going to speed up just a little bit. So actually we're only doing 60, so there wasn't much point in using the Badens on this line. They'll hit it here coming on the downhill, and they might hit it leaving the station. But for this uphill section, they're barely going any faster. And then they have to slow down for here. So the Badens may have been a waste of money on this line. The PLMs probably would have been fine. I don't know. I may change. I may switch out the Baden locomotives onto our oil line or something, and put the PLMs back on the plastics line. We'll see. Or I might just put everything as Badens, just because they're so cool. I really like them. Let's speed up just a little bit more. Pay off some of this loan. Alright, so yeah, we're doing really good speed, so we're almost going to hit top speed before the turn here. So that's a little bit better, I guess. Or not too bad. But yeah, you can see we really cleared this out. But I think production's fallen way off while everything was stopped. So hopefully it'll start coming back up. Production's down here, but we're doing okay on wood again. So that seems to be working okay. Production's almost nothing there though. So now that our plastics line is getting back up to speed, everything should start working again. Where's our other Baden at? Is this him? Yep. What's he got? Okay. Well, we didn't get nearly as much done in this episode as I want to. Let's just take a quick look back over here. Is this even working? No, why is this not... apparently I just barely placed this in the wrong spot. Let's upgrade the road a little bit. Yeah, we can just do that. Screw it, just do it all, it doesn't matter. Okay, is it line usage? No. Why? That's in range, so... Okay, so something's going wrong here. So this says it's connected. But this isn't connected. Do I, like, need to delete the road or something? I'm not sure what's going on here. So, okay, it's saying it's not connected. But why? Because it definitely is. I mean, it's right there. Okay, so there we go. Now it finally fixed itself. Okay, so that should start bringing in some money. The construction materials will get dropped down here and then into the town. But yeah, so definitely didn't get as much done as I was hoping to in this episode, especially after all the work I did getting these lines set up. But yeah, so that's pretty much going to do it for this episode. I hope you liked it. If you did, hit that like button, subscribe, share it with your friends, and I'll see all of you in the next episode.